In Natick, Massachusetts, it's the 12th annual Candlepin Bowling Championship. Competing for the $10,000 grand prize are top seed Dick O'Connell of Brockton, who qualified with a 468. Three-time champion Tommy Olszta of Sturbridge, who qualified with a 446. Peter Flynn of Woburn, who qualified with a 435. Dan Lasko of Dorchester, who qualified with a 426. And Joe Tavernese of Lynn, who qualified with a 425. Hi, everybody. I'm Don Gillis, and glad to have you all back for the 12th annual championship show. As you know, we have prize money of $10,000. We have five bowlers. We're going to have five strings of candlepin bowling, and that's going to be three single-string matches and a final, which will be two strings. $10,000 goes to the winner. $5,000 goes to the runner-up. $2,500 will go to our third-place bowler, and the two who are eliminated in the first matches will receive $1,250 each, plus, of course, any prize money that they are able to get, any of the bonuses. Each of the bowlers also will have a permanent souvenir, a handsome trophy from the Ace Trophy Company of Boston to take home to indicate that they were participants in our 12th annual championship show. And working with me today is a former winner of this program and also our current defending champion on the men's side, Tim Lipke of Londonderry, New Hampshire. His will be the other voice which you will be hearing. Now, I'm going to explain to you the way this works, and it will be number two, that of course is Tom Olszta, against Joe Tavernese in our first match. Then it will be Peter Flynn against Dan Lasko in our next match. The winners will move on and have another single string roll off. The winner of that will challenge our top seed, Dick O'Connell of Brockton, who will be sitting there for a while waiting to find out who he's going to roll against. We'll get underway with it right after this.
Candlepin Bowling is sponsored in part by your neighborhood True Value Hardware Store.
A light bulb is more than a great idea. It's one way True Value Hardware Stores help make your home more secure. Brighten your yard with this instant on quartz floodlight, only $10.99. Then earn a $4 rebate with this TrueGuard Mercury Vapor Yard Light that covers up to 16,000 square feet. Add beauty and security with energy-saving GE Miser flood lamps and earn a $1 rebate. Then work overtime with the GE Bright Stick and earn a $2 mail-in rebate at participating True Value Hardware Store.
New Chicken Little sandwiches from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Chicken Little's your one, so tender and so sweet. Little bitty pretty ones, my 39th century. Chicken Little's your one, you taste so good to me.
They cost just a little, but people love them a lot.
All my life, I've been waiting. Today there'll be no hesitating, no Buick. Your luxury, all Buick. The world will see that you were meant for me.
The big one is back. Buick announces 1.9 APR financing or up to $1,000 cash back on most new 1987 Buicks. But don't hesitate. See your Buick dealer today.
Oh, Buick, I've seen the light. I'm gonna drive my Buick tonight.
Sonny, I want you to do me a favor. I want you to help your mother with the dishes.
I can't do that, Godfather.
I want you to clean up your room.
Sorry, Godfather.
Okay, I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse. Smooth, creamy Jell-O pudding.
Jell-O Instant Pudding and sugar-free Jell-O Instant Pudding. Kids love them, and they're ready in just 5 minutes.
Godfather, you have my every loyalty.
Okay, we are underway, and the first ball will be thrown by Joe Tavernese of Lynn. He is the current state champion. One pin to pick up. He has the two pin. Nice for Joe Tavernese. Joe is the manager of the post office lanes in Lynn, Massachusetts.
Go, JT!
League average 125. High single 191. High triple 453. Five is the fill. And he's left with almost a spread eagle. He gets a couple. Two and four. And now takes out 6 and 10 for a 9 box. Now here is Tom Olszta, our second seed from Sturbridge, Massachusetts. League average 130. Tommy, considered by many to be the outstanding candlepin bowler of this era. He's a three-time winner on this program, on this particular show. Piece of wood rolling off into the gutter. Ralph Stewart takes a look at it and says, okay, go. It's an 8-box to begin for Tom Olszta. Tong's high single 209, high triple 496. I told you his league average 130. Both of these men, Joe Tavernese and Tom Olszta, competing against each other, are bowling lane managers. Joe Tavernese is the manager of the post office lanes in Lynn, and Tom Olszta is the manager of the bowling alley, the Hippodrome lanes in Southbridge, Massachusetts. Good effort. Is that how you would have played it, Tim?
I'm not sure. I think I might have gone for the three pins and tried to flip it over into the one.
I think there are a few folks from Lynn here today.
Just a few. Got a beautiful crowd here today. And I must tell you, it's a privilege working beside you today. Thank you.
Thanks, Tim. All right, Joe Tavernese working on number one right now. Everything except the seven.
Pick it up, Joe, pick it up.
And it's a 9-box. Now on to lane three.
Depending upon where the wood ends up on this, I think Joe's going to go for the 5-pin on the left-hand side to try and kick it over into the 10.
He did it! Now the pressure, of course, goes on to Tom Olszta because this is a one-string. There you see how it was made, a one-string roll-off, and that's a lot of pressure on a bowler. Right, Tim? Tommy Olszta now does not have what you'd call an easy spare leave here with the...
Going after the wood.
All right, made it. That is pretty. Look at how he made it.
Four pin is the object point, which puts the wood into the seven and the nine.
Two pull, and all he gets is five, and he's left with a tough split. Almost a spread eagle. Joe Tavernese had this. And he leaves two, so it's an 8-box. And we're going to take a check on that scoreboard, which Al Giglio is keeping for us over on the left. With Joe Tavernese still having a bonus ball to roll, he's at 43, Tom Olszta at 40.
Newmark get set, go. Countdown days in your Toyota dealer. The 87s have got to go to make room for the 88s. Want to save on a new Toyota? You can count on it with thousands of new 87s at low prices with special deals. Factory-to-dealer incentives can save you hundreds, even free options on limited edition trucks. Your Toyota dealer will do whatever it takes to make your deal
during Toyota Countdown Days. But hurry, time is counting down, because when the 87s are gone, they're gone!
Crimson Travel says, discover Club Med, where you leave your cares and worries behind and your money behind, too. Just about everything's included in the Club Med vacation. Tennis, sailing, water sports, all free, including equipment and instruction, too. And every meal is a French feast. Enjoy the exciting Club Meds in the Caribbean or Bermuda and Cancun with direct flights from Boston. Choose your pace. Do everything or do nothing. For Club Med reservations, call Crimson Travel.
I got a taste for one with the juice. I want the orange that turns it loose. We got a surface something cool and light. All we need is mandarin orange pie. With Tempest and juice, we got the juice.
Until now, there's been no effective way to stop fleas and ticks from getting on your pet. Now, revolutionary new Blockade from Hartz does just that. Hartz Blockade Repellent may just be your pet's best friend. You simply spray it on. It's this easy, and it repels fleas and ticks even before they get on your pet. Hartz is so confident, they're offering your money back if Blockade is not the best product on the market for flea and tick control that you've ever used. Hartz Blockade, your pet's best friend.
We are back live at the Fairway in Natick, Massachusetts. Our 12th annual Candlepin Championship show. Joe Tavernese working on a spare, and he has a 9-pin drop. Current Massachusetts Bowling Association champion.
I think everybody would like one to shoot like.
His third mark. Paul Olszta has but one.
I think we could even get those done. What do you think?
With a nice piece of wood across a single pin? Yeah, I might. I just might. I know you would. Joe Tavernese gets himself a 7-pin drop here, and he's left with 2, 4, 10, and a couple of pieces of wood.
Joe's going to be shooting for the 2 and the 4 on this and try and kick that wood over into the 10-pin.
Just missing that, and you know yourself that... That happens often when you're trying to brush by that 2. It's an eye. Now, Tom Olszta, who has not, in the first four boxes, been typically Tom Olszta with an 8, 9, spare 5, and an 8. But I don't think there's anybody who would sell him short.
Not Tommy. Tommy can come back so fast on anybody.
Here's a spare leap. This can be tricky when there's no wood. You can sometimes get one.
Very easy to punch out that 4-pin on this shot.
No question there. Beautiful. Left side, beautiful. Bonus ball. Thin hit, 6. Now 2, 4, and 7 and 10. Play it the same way, Tim?
Yeah, shooting for the 2, 4, trying to split them. Get the 3, and the 2-pin goes over into the 10.
He tried to play wood that time. Did that surprise you?
I don't think that's what Tommy was aiming for.
Think it just, he dropped it too soon?
I think he got away from him.
Come on, Joe, baby, right here!
Tonight. Four boxes to go. 13-pin lead for Joe Tavernese in this one string roll-off. And we're live, I remind you, here at the Fairway. A spare lead for Joe Tavernese. 2, 4, and 5. Just one of them.
Yeah.
eight box. That's the lowest in any box that Joe Tavernese has had. He's had spare 5-9-9, spare 9, spare 7-9, and now this 8 in the seventh box.
Joe doesn't want to let up too much on here. Tommy will come right back at him.
A punch out, almost a spread eagle. One pin, the 9 pin, still standing. Otherwise, it's a spread eagle. What does that do now? What does that do to you when you've done that and you have one ball left?
Makes you worry a lot, I'll say that much. He's got to come out of here with a nice out.
A 5.
Leaves the door open for
that. That opened the door for Tom Olszta. Now let's see whether he can walk through it or not. This is 1-2-10. No wood. Two full. It's a 9. That picks up one pin.
Tom gets
now the lead
here.
Is 12.
To be interesting.
He's opposite a 5 box. Now, as that wood rolled out of there, this makes that shot very, very tough, 2-8. How come it's so easy when you punch it out as a half Worcester?
I think it's because you got 10 pins staring at you, not 2. He's got to nail that 2 pin awfully high. Oh.
Nope. So the best he can do is pick up 5 pins.
He gets a 10, he still gains 5 on him.
All right, the lead is 7. Final 2 boxes. We are down to a 7-pin lead for this man, Joe Tavernese, over Tom Olszta. Final 2 boxes. Two, four, six. That's a tough one.
Yeah, you got to catch the 2-pin awfully light. Kick it into the...
Ooh, a miss.
Not that light.
Pick him up, Joe. Pick him up.
The referee who is directly behind the bowlers today is Don Riley, and our lob line judge and referee, Ralph Stewart, in his accustomed spot at the lob line. Here's Joe Tavernese now with his final box. Remember, it's just one string.
There's a nice break.
There's Ralph sitting in his accustomed spot right at the lob line. 1-2 for Joe Tavernese. He's waiting for wood to settle down. As you well know, when you've been watching us, we adhere absolutely to the rules of candlepin bowling, and we must wait for rolling wood to stop rolling. Joe Tavernese, with his 125 average and his high single of 186, hoping for a mark right now. He has it.
That shot. This forces Tommy to have to throw a mark.
Now he wants a big one. 8, 9, or 10. You can't have it. A lob.
That hurt.
A lob. A lob. A lob. Ralph Stewart has just called a lob. So it is a 0 fill. Talos on the line. Trailing by 7. The door is open for Tom. Let's see what happens here now. 2-10.
Object is the 2-pin on this. And where that wood is lined up, it should go right into the 10.
He did not get it.
That surprises me. I thought he had that. Gotta have a mark.
He needs a mark. He must mark. Absolutely must mark.
That lob could be a big factor.
All right, he's got 1-10. Ralph Stewart looking at this, and if it stops, and it's going to, this side of the lob line, the deadwood line, It is going to be removed, and it cannot help Tom. He's going to have to make a spare of a 110 on his own.
Got to catch that 5-pin on the left-hand side and throw it into
it
the pen.
It is 5 and 10, yes. Joe Tavernese. So, Tom Olszta is eliminated in the first string. Joe Tavernese moves on. Despite the lob, he still moves on. He does not believe it was a lob. But it was. All right, we're going to be back with our second match. That will be another single string. This will be between our third and fourth bowlers. We'll do that right after I can tell you that Joe Tavernese advances over Tom Olszta 110 to 103.
Manigee knows just how you feel. You want a quality muffler that doesn't cost a lot.
Say, you big ape! I'm not going to pay a lot for this muffler!
I'm not going to pay a lot for this muffler, and it better be quality!
We're not going to pay a lot for this muffler, and we want quality!
No problem. Our quality Everlast mufflers are priced from just $18.93 to $26.95 installed.
Oh, I'm not going to pay a lot, and still get quality!
I got a feeling for my hometown. I know the streets, I know my way around.
At Century 21, we've never forgotten how we started out. And even though today we bring more buyers and sellers together than any other real estate system, even though we've become the number one home selling system in America, we still do it one home at a time.
I got a feeling for my hometown.
Century 21, the hometown advantage.
Hemorrhoids, they hurt, burn, and swell. And more doctors recommend Anusol to relieve the hurting than all other hemorrhoid medicines combined. Anusol is the word to remember for relief.
The Greenland Eskimos. Studies link their low incidence of heart disease to a fish diet rich in omega-3. Only Promega, cholesterol-free Promega, has the highest percentage concentration of natural omega-3. All natural, more omega-3, cholesterol-free.
Dan Lasko on the line as we begin our second single string roll-off. Dan was our fourth place qualifier. And he'll be rolling against third place Peter Flynn. Spare leave right away. Piece of wood right beside two and four. There you see it. Joe Tavernese has advanced over Tommy Olszta. Now it's Lasko against Flynn to determine who will roll against Tavernese. And the eventual winner then will be in a two-string roll-off against our top seed, Dick O'Connell. For Lasko, it's a fill of seven. How do you play this one?
Well, I think Dan's going to go after the three-pin. And hopefully the wood will do some acting for him.
Oddly enough, the wood did the acting, but he didn't touch the three pin. I'm not saying he didn't want to. Of course he did. All right, now Peter Flynn. Fine left-handed bowler. There's Peter Flynn of Woburn. He qualified with a 435. Lasko with a 426. For those of you who are seeing our championship show for the first time, it's live. These are the five bowlers who have had the highest three-string total since our last championship show. And Peter Flynn, too full on the head pin. He thought he had that one, I'm sure.
It's very close to being a lob as well. Had to watch Ralph on that one to see what he was up to over there.
Ralph, of course, as Tim Lipke points out, is sitting right on the lob line. Lob is called. So they'll be reset. And he's rolling too.
I think nerves are playing a factor right now. Everybody's still a little uptight.
Well, you can speak from experience. You won this thing. Were you Were you up a little tight?
I think I'm a little more nervous right now than I was back then.
All right, that was what we call a skip lob. It's legal because the first contact the ball made was this side of the lob line. In the previous instances with both Peter Flynn and Joe Tavernese, the ball made its first contact with the lane beyond the lob line. So that's a 10. A disappointment for Peter Flynn. Dan Lasko coming up. And remember, as I told you before, Ralph Stewart sits directly on the lob line. He looks right down at it.
Wow.
Right down the middle, 1-5 punch out, not even a spread eagle. You saw Dan's statistics. Average 120, high single 192, his high triple is 486. That's a disappointing 6 for Dan Lasko. He's representing Lucky Strike Lanes in Dorchester. He is a warehouse selector for Monarch Foods in Everett, Massachusetts. There's a big hit by Lasko. One pin to pick up the 10. Is this easier for a left-hander to go across lane?
I think it's easier for a lefty, yes.
Made it! And conversely, the 7 would be easier for you as a right-hander. All right, Peter Flynn, the left-hander, coming up now. Peter works for A.W. Chesterton Company. Well, no object pin. 3 pieces of wood. Obviously, we see where that one piece of wood is going to finally stop, the one that's in the middle. Well, it's no longer in the middle.
Still think he's going to use it.
Oh, yeah, I would think so, too. And then there are the 2 pieces of wood behind it, and 7 and 10.
Try and catch it right around where the stripe is on that piece of wood that's angled, and hopefully the ball will take the 10 and the pin will take the 7.
Let's see, right on that red that time.
Yeah, hit it right on the red. A little bit higher, I think, than what he wanted.
Ralph Stewart wants to take a look at the loose ball, get it out of the way.
Until Ralph knows we're alive, he's moving a little faster.
Right on the nose that time for Peter Flynn for his 3rd successive 10 box.
Otherwise known as a perfect game so far.
Boy, that's tough when that 5 stays up there. Now you've got parallel pins in the 4 and 5 and also in the 7 and 8. Piece of wood is your only chance here, isn't it, to try to maybe keep it?
I think the shot would be easier for a righty than it is a lefty.
All right, now Peter will go for these 2 to try to keep it at 4 tens. He has it. All right, at the end of 4, here in the 2nd of our elimination strings, Dan Lasko still has a bonus ball to roll. He's at 43 plus that. Peter Flynn, 40.
You couldn't play the stock market 7 days a week until now. Priscilla Stone won $2,500 playing the Boston Herald's Cash in the Market. So did John Silva. Cash in the Market gives you free stocks every Sunday and a chance to win up to $2,500 every day. Nicholas Healy won $1,000. So did Francis Piotrowski. And all these people were winners, too. Now the market is open 7 days a week. Get 3 new stocks this Sunday and play every day in the Boston Herald.
Hello. Oh, hi, honey. Dinner. Well, we can have a spinach salad.
With Good Seasons, you can make most anything on your mind.
Red wine vinegar with olive oil and Good Seasons Italian. Oh, wait a second.
Oh, no.
How about a chef's salad? Olive mayo and sour cream.
Oh, hold on.
A vegetable salad with Dijon mustard dressing. Okay, see you later.
Good Seasons salad dressing mix. From one packet, the ideas keep pouring out.
So, here's my forecast for tomorrow. An early morning shower is possible, followed by dry, gusty wind. Then, just a tad warmer, with high pressure slowly moving in, making it just ducky in the afternoon. But I'm tracking a storm for you later on.
News Center 5's Dick Albert. He brings the weather down to earth.
But remember, tonight will be a real sizzler.
Dan Lasko on the line. I'm Don Gillis along with Tim Lipke. We are live from the fairway in Natick, Massachusetts, the 12th annual Candlepin Championship show. The five top bowlers since our last show, competing for a first prize of $10,000, runner-up $5,000. Dan Lasko is working on a spare that time, and he gets five. Now the 1, 3, 7, 9, and 10.
Just missed his object pin.
Dan is a single father. He has a daughter, Ashley.
Now, there's an old theory that lefties have a little bit more of a break on lanes than right-handed bowlers because there aren't that many lefties in this game.
Does that mean you don't like to face a left-hander?
Well, if you ask some lefties, and I'm sure Peter would say the same thing, it's the right-handed bowler, a lot of times it gets a groove in the lane, even though the candlepin ball doesn't weigh that much, and it's more or less a new lane for any lefty that comes into a house.
5 and 10. Once upon a time, referred to as the Woolworth, but I don't know how many Woolworth 5 and 10s there are anymore. Shows you how old I am. Dan Lasko has a 10. All right, Peter Flynn coming up now, trailing by 8 pins, looking for his first mark. Peter's married, has 2 sons, Craig and Sean. He's representing the Granada lanes in Malden. Big, big hit. Peter Flynn gets the hammer. There it is.
Can't say too much about this. He buried the ball right in the 1-2 pocket.
First bonus ball from the tall left-hander. Kind of a thin hit. He's got 4 horsemen right side and has 4-7 on the left. No, so the total is just 5. And he'll be lucky if he gets an 8 box.
If he gets the 3 on the right-hand side, he'll be doing well.
Oh, baby, got them all. How about that? Watch the 3 on the right go down. Now look at this dancing pin. Oh, thank you very much.
Fantastic shot, you betcha.
Now, Dan Lasko, 2 pins. That's the difference right now. Remember, this is one man out, single string.
And he's going to have to be careful because a lot of times we leave them.
Oh, nice, nice spare for Dan Lasko. Wow, what a pretty spare that was. Watch this.
Usually on that shot, you leave the 9 pin hanging and you get the other 4.
4 boxes to go for Peter Flynn. 3 more for Dan Lasko. Thin hit, and he's unhappy about that. Just 3, as Al Giglio writes that down on the scoreboard.
Danny will be going for the 4 on the side. No, going the other way.
Thought sure he'd go towards the 247 side.
Anytime you've got wood between your pins, it'll react different ways.
Wow, a 5 box. That hurt. Now Peter Flynn coming up with the door open a little bit, trailing by 2 opposite a spare 3 and a 5. So that was not a very productive pair of boxes for Dan Lasko. Peter Flynn, he held that ball just a tiny bit too long and missed what he wanted, the head pin. Everything except the 10 pin. So close.
Mm-hmm.
Made it. Now the difference is five pins, but he's opposite a five-pin box. We're getting down to the end of this one. Remember, our producer, director is Phil Rubin. He's the man who puts it together all year long, and he's running the show today for us. Emmons Levine is the assistant director working beside me right now, making sure that I do the things right. He's got a hammer right over my head. Okay, here goes Peter Klim, and he did not get it. And back in the studio, Janie Cartier, who's usually here with us, is putting in the slow-mo for us back at the studio. All right, that does it. With two boxes to go, they are tied, 85-85. And remember, it's one man out.
As of yet, no bonus money made. That's surprising.
Yeah, no bonus money at all. Of course, we have our regular three marks in a row. Any combination of strikes or spares, $50 in bonus money. Three strikes in a row, an additional bonus of $1,000. Dan Lasko. No mark here, and he's going to have difficulty in getting himself a big box, too. Looks like maybe he can get an eight.
Danny's looking for a big out on this one. Probably going to use the wood.
Eight it is. Now down to the final box in this particular roll-off.
Dan wants
Dan
the
Lasko.
Mark here.
Oh, does he ever.
Put a little bit of pressure on, Peter.
That's quite a cluster there. One, two, five, eight, nine.
Dan wants to go for the one, two, and hopefully he won't leave the nine.
All right.
Leaving the door open for Peter.
Okay. 17. All right, that means he needs 18 pins to win. Thin hit for Peter Flynn. Be no mark.
Peter looks like he's rushing his approach just a little bit, and he's coming up on it right at the end.
He has a 10. He needs eight pins. Eight. He needed eight. He got it. Now we'll see what his final total will be. Perfect hit.
Eight right in a hurry. He knocked them all down.
Three in a row would be $1,000. $1,050, actually. He has two. He has two. All right, stand by. Three strikes in a row is worth $1,050.
Can't say too much on that one. He buried it right where he put the other one.
He's already guaranteed $2,500 just by moving into the next bracket. Flynn, who came through in the final box. All I can do is ache Mel Allen and say, how about that?
The only time
what a
Peter
fantastic finish to that string for Peter Flynn. Wow, look at him. Three strikes in a row, not only to win the string, but to win $1,050 extra in bonus money. And his final score as he moves it to the next bracket is 125-102.
The 1988 Chevrolet Beretta, a new kind of performance car for those who appreciate
the not so straight and narrow.
The big one's back, and Chevy's got it. 1.9% financing on this big choice of new Chevy cars and trucks, or up to $1,000 cash back. The big one could be the best reason to see your Chevy dealer now.
At Somerville Lumber, we're going to reward you. Save on your beautiful new bathroom now at Somerville Lumber. See the largest selection of complete top-to-bottom bathrooms, including fixtures, vanities, cabinets, and accessories on display to make your shopping easier, and all at guaranteed low Somerville Lumber prices. Let our trained professionals help you with your bathroom project. And when you're through, we'll deliver it all absolutely free.
Don't do it yourself without us.
Somerville Lumber.
Joe Tavernese on the line. Now we find out who faces Dick O'Connell. This is a single string roll-off to determine who will challenge our top seed, Dick O'Connell. Here's Joe Tavernese. He, as you know, moved in here by defeating Tom Olszta in the first. Let's see whether he can do anything here. No, boy, he held that ball much too long. That kind of stuck to his fingers a little, didn't it, Tim?
I think so. Because it's hard sitting out a string and then watching Peter throw a triple in the last box, too.
All right, it's an eight. Okay, Tyrannese by defeating Olszta. And Flynn by defeating Lasko move into this second bracket. The winner of this will face our top seed, Dick O'Connell. We are live, I remind you. This is happening just as you are watching it.
Go, JP!
No videotape today except on slow-mo replay.
Joe's going after the 2-4. Try and split those.
Wood rolling, but not hard enough.
Actually,
now,
hit
a piece
of
wood.
Too heavy.
Yeah, he did. It was sort of a like landing in mud.
Pick it up, Joe. Pick it up.
An 8 and a 10. Now, Peter Flynn, I wonder how much that three strikes in a row and the way he won it is going to affect him. I'd be tingling all over. I don't think I could even pick up the ball.
I'm sure he is.
Wouldn't have been something if he had brought a strike that time. To imagine four in a row, but they have to be in the same string.
It's a nice way to finish, but you'd rather start out that way.
All right, Ralph Stewart has removed a piece of deadwood. I told you before, there is a line. It is exactly 24 inches this way toward the bowler from the middle of the head pin. If a piece of wood is behind it, it remains. If it touches it or comes this side, it has to be removed. Spare in the first for Peter Flynn. Would you say that he's a little warm right now?
I would not want to have to go up against him right now.
There it is, right in another strike pocket for Peter Flynn. Now Joe Tavernese on the line. He's looking for his first mark. And this, our third string of live bowling in our championship show.
Would be some stat. You put the triple together plus these two marks and then next string.
Joe Tavernese now looking at a 2-4-7, no wood to help. Oh, surprise! And the crowd, and there is a large crowd from Lynn here. Happy to see Joe get that one. Not as happy as he is, I'll tell you that. All right, spare in the third for Joe. He wants to load up right now. Eight. And it sure is a lot better than facing the diamond.
That last spare Joe had is one of those shots where you turn around and say, piece of cake.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
Joe's had quite a year this year, winning the Mass States, all events.
And of course, he was tied by Bob Reynolds, and then we had to go into our tiebreaker to the number of marks, then the number of strikes, and Joe was able to edge Bob Reynolds because of that, which is the tiebreaker that we have used all along. All right, Peter Flynn trying to make it three marks in a row here in this string. Just two that time as he just missed the head pin. He can still come back and make a spare. It would be worth $50 in bonus money. Nope, not now. So, Peg Philbrook, who is working as a statistician, is marking down for him the 1,050 so far, the only bonus money that we have for any of our bowlers. It's an eye. As I told you, Dick O'Connell is our top seed. He's sitting back, just waiting to see who's going to challenge him in a two-string roll-off, and that should be something. Almost another strike for Peter Flynn. At the moment, a 10-pin lead in this single string.
Peter should have no problem with this shot. Nothing's blocking his six pin whatsoever.
He has it. All right, we're going to take another check on the scoreboard after four boxes here in this third string of our 12th annual championship show. And right now, with a bonus ball to roll, Peter Flynn is at 56 and Joe Tavernese 46.
In these days of self-service gas stations, computerized banking, and understaffed stores, it seems that no one has the time for personal service anymore. Well, at True Value Hardware Stores, we haven't forgotten that we're working for you. And whenever you have a question or a problem with a do-it-yourself project, we'll do our very best to help. So the next time someone wonders where personal service has gone, you tell them it's still hard at work. Right in here. True Value, more than just a name. It's our way of doing business.
You'd no more settle for a flake in your hair than a spot on your tie. You passed the test to good grooming, has the look of success. Your head and shoulders above the rest. One flake can mean dandruff. Regular shampoos may rinse flakes, but head and shoulders protection goes to the source to help stop flakes.
And that's doing it right.
Your head and shoulders above the rest.
Hyundai dealers and their families are just itching to take their vacations, but they can't go until the 87 XLs go. So to clear them out, it's summer break days at Hyundai, with lots of cars to choose from. Seven models under $7,000 and starting at just $51.95. With the 88s coming, the 87s have got to go. Let's face it, he's got a lot of pressure on him to put you in a new Hyundai right now.
Oh, come on, dear. Give him a good deal.
It's summer break days, and for your nearest Eastern New England Hyundai dealer, call toll-free 826-CARS.
Joe Tavernese of Lynn on the line right now. Is that tantalizing? Tim?
9.5.
What do you pay? 9.5. Does it do any good to stamp your foot? Only in frustration, I guess. That's
yeah,
all.
Not unless you gain a lot of weight like I did.
Oh, roadblock. Too
That's
bad.
That's not what Joe wanted to do.
No.
He wants to start right marking to put a little bit of pressure back on Peter.
A 10. Joe Tavernese, in case any of you are just tuning in, and if you are, you've missed a lot of action so far in this live show, just to inform you, Joe is the current Massachusetts State All-Events Champion. He won the first of our one-string roll-offs by defeating Tom Olszta, a three-time winner on this show. And the voice you hear other than mine belongs to Tim Lipke, who is also a former winner of this big biggie.
I think Joe wanted those two pins to stay up. It's a lot easier shooting at the four horsemen on the right than it is the 110.
Uh-huh.
Waiting for a piece of wood to settle down. Despite the fact that Joe survived that first string after having a lob called on a big, what would have been a fill on a spare, he survived it in defeating Tom Olszta. But it may have unnerved him a little bit and made him think just a little bit as he delivers the ball. What do you think, Tim?
I think it's playing a factor in Joe. You've got to be thinking that you don't want to lob anymore, especially if you throw a spare and then come back with a strike like he did. Wow.
How about that? Now, you tell me any other bowling, any kind, where you can hit the head pin like that and punch out just two, a one and a nine. If you come in on the head pin, you get something.
He's just going to be all right, let's see. Good out on this one.
Oh, is he ever. Well, you just saw how to make a come-from-behind, backdoor, cross-alley, whatever you want to call it, 10.
I was going to suggest how to play that, but I think I'd keep my mouth shut on that one.
I think that was wise, Tim, for both of us. Peter Flynn, four horsemen right side, and on the left side, four and seven, with wood in between the four and seven.
They always say there's the right way and the wrong way.
The wood to settle down to see whether he's going to lead by 10, 11, or 12. It's by 12. All right, Joe Tavernese, four boxes to go. But believe me, he is very capable of having an explosive four boxes. Five and seven.
Considering Peter's got three marks and Joe's only got one, 12 pins is not much to make up. You consider two marks and...
Another box gone, though. He's down to three boxes now.
Joe's having a hard time finding his object pin right now.
As you're running out of boxes like this now, Tim, do you start to press? It would be natural, I would think.
You try not to, but you can't help it. Especially when you're the first bowler up and Peter.
Well, there's a break. Three pins to pick up for a spare. 2-4-7.
A lot of bowlers like to be last, so they know what they have to hit. Other bowlers like going first to put pressure on the second bowler. So there's pros and cons both ways.
How does Tim Lipke like it?
To be ahead.
You mean, well, I know you want to be ahead, but I mean, do you want to lead off?
I actually like going last.
You know what you have to do.
I know what I have to do, and a lot of times you seem to concentrate a little bit extra.
Oh, that's the second time that Joe has had that spare leave and did not get the seven pin.
Hits his logic pin, and it just...
A nine box.
Four pin goes right around the seven.
All right, Peter Flynn leading by 12 in completed frames here in this one-string elimination. Remember, we're going to have a two-string final. We are live, and these bowlers are going for a first prize of $10,000.
Peter's going to want to split the 2-4 over in the 6-10 if he can. I think the skip law bothered him on that one.
I remember and thinking how unfair it was back in the days when they used to call the skip lob a lob. Finally took care of that. All right. 11. That's the lead. Look at that again. Same two pins out of there, the one and the nine.
Peter's out there saying, I hit the head pin.
Right. And that's what he must remember. I'm sure that it becomes very frustrating when you start getting spread eagles, but you do have to keep saying to yourself, I am hitting the head pin.
You don't want to move around the approach too much, because if you're hitting your object pin and you start moving, it's going to cause problems with your approach that much more.
He ties him with a 9 in that box. He still has an 11-pin lead. Two boxes to go. All right, Joe Tavernese coming up now in his final two boxes, perhaps. Certainly the final two boxes of this.
Not high scores, but they're going right down to the wire.
Big, 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 big hit for Joe Tavernese. Strike in the 9.
Exactly what
that's how it went.
Bury it right in the 1-4. They all went down fast.
Two full that time, coming right in on the head pin.
Okay, all Joe wants to do on this is to pin out, get a nice fill on the strike, and then hopefully grab a 10 box.
Oh, too bad.
Not what he wanted to do.
No, 5 was the fill. It's an 8, 108. He put Peter in the position of having to mark.
Yeah, if Joe could have got 2 marks in the last couple boxes, that would have put the pressure on Peter.
All right, Peter has a single pin to pick up, the 5.
Have the feeling that Peter likes the last 2 boxes.
Boy, in that first string against Dan Lasko, he certainly did. All right, there's his mark. He had to have it. He got 4, that's it. I gotta go back and do my arithmetic again. I was saying that he had to have it and he didn't have to have it. He only needed 12 pins. See, I get excited too. Listen, the folks who watch all the time know that I can't do arithmetic. Okay. Final score. Peter Flynn is going to move on to a 2-string roll-off with a first prize of $10,000. That's stake, $5,000 for the runner-up against Dick O'Connell. And he did it by defeating Joe Tavernese 119-108.
You couldn't play the stock market 7 days a week until now. Priscilla Stone won $2,500 playing the Boston Herald's Cash in the Market. So did John Silva. Cash in the Market gives you free stocks every Sunday and a chance to win up to $2,500 every day. Nicholas Healy won $1,000. So did Francis Piotrowski. And all these people were winners too. Now the market is open 7 days a week. Get 3 new stocks this Sunday and play every day in the Boston Herald.
A light bulb is more than a great idea. It's one way True Value Hardware stores help make your home more secure. Brighten your yard with this instant-on quartz floodlight, only $10.99. Then earn a $4 rebate with this True Guard Mercury Vapor Yard Light that covers up to 16,000 square feet. Add beauty and security with energy-saving GE Miser flood lamps and earn a $1 rebate. Then work overtime with the GE Bright Stick and earn a $2 mail-in rebate at participating True Value Hardware stores.
Looking for something wonderful? Here's a delicious place to start, with a warm cup of Cinnamony Cafe Vienna. And while we're talking wonderful, we've teamed up with Spiegel and created a terrific little catalog that's in September magazines, with everything from workout wear to evening wear. And right now, when you buy General Foods International Coffees, you can save up to 30% on what's in the catalog. General Foods International Coffees and Spiegel, 2 ways to celebrate great taste.
All right, here's Peter Flynn. He hasn't had time to rest. Here he is now, leading off in the 2-string final. He's the challenger in this instance, since Dick O'Connell, who is our top seed, will still roll second.
Peter's first ball looked better than what he just ended up with.
And he almost pulled it off. One pin, the 10 pin over in the corner. There it is. Peter Flynn has defeated Dan Lasko in his first one-string roll-off, then Joe Tavernese in the second. He is now facing top seed Dick O'Connor. At the moment, waiting for that tantalizing piece of wood to settle down. A 10. Now Peter moves to lane three here at the fairway in Natick, Massachusetts, where this show is coming to you live. Almost the spread eagle. This time the nine stayed there.
I happened to watch Dick when he threw that 464 that day. Boy, was he hot.
A seven bunch. All right, now here he is. Here is our top seed. And since the very beginning of the show when he threw that one ball, we haven't seen him, and he's been sitting back here. What does that do, Tim, do you think, to a guy who sits back here for a full hour before he gets a chance to work?
Normally, if anybody was hot, I would say it would really bother him. Where the scores... thought he might get lucky a little bit there, but...
Was he doing that on purpose? I can't believe it.
I don't believe so. I think the ball just got away from him.
High single, 197. It's the 10. Dick representing the Maple Lanes in Brockton. And qualified Timber Lanes in Abington. He is an electrical contractor, a single father of two. From Brockton, Massachusetts. Three pins on the left, two on the right.
Nice bid.
Do you find that when working on the spread eagle, or that almost a spread eagle, that the right-hander is more apt to go to the right side, the left-hander to the left side to try to make it?
I think so, yes.
It's the way your ball is breaking. If it has any break at all, we'll be breaking in a little bit at that particular time. All right, here's Peter Flynn. Remember, this is a two-string roll-off. First prize, $10,000. Runner-up gets $5,000 and any and all bonus money. And the bonus money we have seen today all belongs to Peter Flynn. He had three marks in a row worth $50 in bonus money. The fact that they were strikes gave him an extra $1,000.
Peter's still having trouble with his approach a little bit. He seems to be pushing just a little bit extra.
The rolling wood slowing things down a little bit. But we'll be here to the bitter end.
Okay, Peter.
Tuppy without wood, four and five side by side, and right behind them, seven and eight.
And I don't think that wood's going to be worth even using.
Ho, ho, ho! Boy. Now, you see what it's like to be an announcer?
They prove you wrong every time.
Oh, he almost pulled that off with that.
He sure did.
Work.
O'Connell coming up now. Our top seed getting set to roll here on lane two. Now Stewart had to go down there and get rid of a ball that seems to refuse to go off the deck. Now Dick O'Connell. One, three, eight. Sidewall action brought the eight pin down. 6, that's the bill. 1, 3, 9, and 10. And Wood in back of that 3.
Still not too bad. He's got the 1-3 with that wood in between. It should carry. The only pin he's got to watch out for is the 9 pin.
You're right. The 9 pin was standing, but the sidewall action brought it down. So the score at the end of 4 in the first of our two final roll-off strings, Dick O'Connell with a bonus ball to roll 45, Peter Flynn 36.
What won't cost you a cent but will save you a fortune? The Window Wizard's free catalog. Big savings on Anderson windows, bays and bows, entrance doors, kitchens and building materials. Window Wizard's beats any advertised price. Shop at home and get delivery.
Call today for your free Window Wizards catalog. 1-800-922-8060. That's 1-800-922-8060. Why pay more?
We got the juice.
We got a hit.
We got the blast.
Sprite and 7-Up miss.
We got the juice.
And for the great taste of orange,
we got the juice,
we got the juice,
we got the fresh,
we got the taste.
Mandarin orange.
Nobody else has.
We got the juice.
In Mandarin orange slice.
Slice, slice.
On your mark, get set, go. Straight to countdown days at your Toyota dealer. He's got to clear out the 87s because the 88s are almost here. You can count the savings. Low prices and special deals. Save more with factory incentives, even free options on limited edition trucks. Toyota dealers have thousands of new 87s, so you can count on great deals. During Toyota countdown days, but hurry, don't be counted out. Because when the 87s are gone, they're gone.
Out here, the scorching sun beats down 200 days a year. Hurricanes rage, and the salt water tries to eat everything in sight. Out here, you paint your house with Pittsburgh paint.
Now at Somerville Lumber, only $13.29 a gallon. And Pittsburgh's quality res stain and wood preservative, just $11.59 a gallon.
Don't do yourself without us.
Somerville Lumber.
Peter Flynn of Woburn, Massachusetts, on the line right now, rolling in the fifth box of the first of two final strings here to determine our champion who's going to win the $10,000. Taking a look at the clock, it's very apparent that we are going to run over, and so we alert everybody to that fact. But we are going to stay here until we find out who is going to be our 12th annual champion. And the winner of the $10,000. By the way, both of these bowlers are former Bowlers of the Year on the World Candlepin Bowling Congress Tour. So I should mention that that WCBC Pro Tour will be starting their 16th season Friday, September 11th at the Rollaway Lanes in Biddeford, Maine. Not much time to enter. Entries close September 9th. Peter Flynn, is he going to get it? No, it's going to stay there.
Almost the back door strike.
You're on that tour, aren't you?
Yeah. As a matter of fact, we are.
And Don Riley?
Oh, he is too.
Fair. As Dick O'Connell comes up, I'll just tell you that you mail your entry to WCBC Incorporated, Box 545, Webster, Massachusetts. All right, now let's concentrate on Dick O'Connell, who's going for 3 marks in a row. He hopes. He's got him! $50 $10 in bonus money for Dick O'Connell. Look at this perfect right pocket hit. Eight pin finally going.
Don is also the WCBC Pro Tour president this year.
Four horsemen left side.
And speaking of awards, we also, as of July 29th, 87, the Pro...
He has four marks in a row. Boy, I'll tell you, sitting out certainly did not bother Dick O'Connell. Look at the way the four horsemen went down. One, two, four, seven, zap.
The bowlers now have a Candlepin Hall of Fame. Even though Tommy's no longer with us for this championship show, he was the first recipient of the President's Award in the Hall of Fame.
Right.
And we'd also, for yourself, like to congratulate you. We understand that you were put into the Hall of Fame for Sportcaster. Congratulations.
And I appreciated it, too, I want to tell you. All right, let's see now whether Peter can make this. No. That has to be hit absolutely perfectly because that one piece of wood cannot be hit on one side or the other if it's going to go through and get two pins like that.
I don't think Peter hit that quite where he wanted. I think he wanted more towards the seven pin on that.
Tough split. 4-7, 6-10.
Peter could go either way on this one, although I think he'll go towards the 6-10.
So you want to be an announcer, huh?
So he proved us wrong again.
That's all right, Tim. I get the mail. I get the mail. Don't try to second guess them. Okay, I'm not.
I got the excuse. I'm righty. Peter's lefty.
All right. Dick O'Connell trying to make it five marks in a row. Just three. It'll be tough to make this five marks in a row, but he's piled up a 24-pin lead. He's waiting for the wood to settle down. That's what he's looking at. No. All right. The bonus stops at four marks in a row. That's $100 that he will get. In addition to whatever he wins, either the $5,000 or the $10,000. Because when you are top seed and you come in here, you sit back while three strings are rolled, and you wait to find out who's going to challenge you, but you are guaranteed $5,000 as soon as you walk in the door. That's why these bowlers try so hard to be the top seed. Four horsemen left side. Now, he made this beautifully the last time. It was absolutely picture perfect. You could have a how-to bowl video on it.
Notice a lot of skip lobs today. I think it's a little bit of tension in the bowlers.
You mean that's why I hit my golf shot spat?
That's another subject.
Last time he went to the outside of that number one pin. This time he went for the 1-2 pocket.
It's the exact reason why a lot of bowlers will play that shot to the outside rather than going for the 1-2 pocket.
It's a nine. All right, we're down to the final two boxes of the first of the two final strings. This is live for the big one, $10,000 first prize. Peter Flynn is just hanging onto that ball a split second, a millisecond too long as he's delivering it, and it's missing the head pin and going into the three instead. Ooh, boy, he did a dance up here for a minute. It looked like it was going to go right in the same spot.
Nice shot.
What a shot for the 10. Oh, baby. Save that one.
I think Peter was just looking for two or three on that one, and as it ended up, he got all four.
What a shot it was.
Wow.
Do you think maybe he was thinking deja vu for a moment there as he threw that one and thought for a second he had a strike?
Okay, Peter, nail it down.
That was a good possibility. The ball was buried right into the pocket. Peter wants this one just to close the gap a little.
All right, he has it. That puts him at 101. Obviously, the best he can do is 111. Let's see how much he can add to his score.
This is the advantage of going what we call the anchor position, because Dick knows that if he can mark out, he can put a lot of pressure on Peter for the next string.
Big, big hit, 110. 110. All right, now Dick O'Connell, who is our top seed, coming up at 104 through 8. A pair of 10s would give him a 124. Oh, nice try. Another box to go.
I think Dick's putting a little bit more what we call over the top spin on the ball than what he normally does. That's why the ball is going right to left on him.
And what causes that? Just a little tension, maybe?
A little bit of tension. Let's see if I can spit it out here. And also,
welcome to the club. Look at that, he just missed that seven as it danced across. So Peter Flynn can only breathe a sigh of relief here.
I think Dick missed that shot just a little bit. He wanted to hit that three pin a little bit harder and force that three over into the seven.
Remember, we have another string to go, and we will stay to the very end, even though we will probably run over. The final of the first of these two strings is Dick O'Connell, 123, Peter Flynn, 110.
Did your last eye exam have a phoropter test, a computerized vision test, a health check for glaucoma and cataracts? And Eye Exam 2000 does. With 20 tests and checks, it adds up to one of the most thorough eye exams you can get. Thoroughness is Eye Exam 2000.
Eye Exam 2000, inside Lens Crafters, Route 1 in Dedham, Wellington Circle Plaza, Medford, and Purity Supreme Plaza, Route 114, Peabody. Open Sundays for your convenience.
The Born Again Car. Every 30 seconds, one is born again at a Maaco Auto Painting and Body Works Center.
Maaco. There's over 400 shops coast to coast.
4 million customers prove Maaco not only gets the job done fast, we get it done right and at the right price. Polyurethane and acrylic enamel oven bake finishes and bodywork by Mako's trained technicians
are backed by a written warranty honored at all locations.
So if your car is an better get Maaco. Your car will be born again.
To celebrate Pepsi's victory over Coke Classic, we're holding Ultimate Choice Sweepstakes. What does it mean? It means we'll whisk you away on a private jet for 10 days of frolic and fantasy. It means you can win a great 10-day trip. Visit a trio of playgrounds preferred by the posh and pampered. You can visit three American cities. Share your good fortune with five grateful companions. It means you can bring five friends. So shampoo. It means good luck. Shampoo.
Enter at participating locations to win the grand prize or 10,000 other prizes.
New improved whisk. It's not just for collars.
It's for dirty skirts, filthy shirts, dusty socks, battered smocks, messy tees, dungarees.
New improved whisk. It gets out ring around the collar and gets your whole wash cleaner than ever. So,
for shorts so bright, tops is white, cleaner best, Sunday best, and all the rest.
New whisk for ring around the collar and a cleaner wash.
Thank you.
Okay, folks, this is it. The final string. Peter Flynn challenging our top seed, Dick O'Connell. Winner gets $10,000. Runner-up, $5,000. Plus, Dick O'Connell's already earned $100 in bonus money for four marks in a row. A 13-pin lead in the match for Dick O'Connell. That's after one. 10 bucks. Now on lane three at the fairway in Natick, Massachusetts, on Route 9, the Worcester Turnpike.
This is where the tension really starts to build.
Oh, I guess so. Wow.
You finally realize you're going for all the marbles.
You should know, you've been there.
He's just going to be trying to go off the two pin, off the wood.
Good try. That was a lovely try. Sounded like Ben Wright then, didn't I?
Ralph's getting a workout today.
The very British golf announcer. He often says, lovely shot. Okay. Pair of tens. Dick O'Connell of Brockton, our top seed. Leading in the match, coming into this by 13. One, two, seven, and eight.
All Dick is thinking right now, if he can throw a couple marks up on the board where Peter's gone open, it just adds to his lead at this point.
There it is. Spare in the first. Watch how it goes. Perfect. 1-2 hit, carried into the wood, wood carried into the 7 and 8. Five is a fill, and just one piece of wood up against the 7. 1-2, 7-9, and 10.
1-2, 7-10 isn't too bad to pick up, but that 9 pin could be a factor.
That's one of the most frustrating shots when you're going for a 1-2 or a 1-3 and you punch out the one, especially when you're trying to get action back of it. A 7 box. So, Peter has to look at that and say, well, he only picked up 2 pins.
Peter's thinking right now is to come back with a nice strike.
Spare leave. No, not really.
Peter hasn't had too much luck with that head pin lately. Nice try.
Good try. Thought for a second that four was going to go. It's still there. 9 bucks. Remember, we're alive, and we are staying until it's over.
A lot of times when you have wood up against the wall like that, it'll deflect off the sidewall.
Strike for Peter Flynn. Peter, who had three of those important strikes in his life earlier. Look at that, how pretty that one went down. Dick O'Connell, a little punch out, half Worcester on the left side.
Again, Dickie's coming up over the top of that ball a little bit too much.
Seven, 10. I can only assume that with Dick O'Connell, he felt great after getting the spare in the first box. Not so great when he got a 5 and wound up with a 7 in that particular thing. Then Peter comes back and shoots a strike at him, and all of a sudden, maybe not quite as loose as he was as he started the string.
I agree with you very much. One box makes a big difference when you're going into a big match as this.
Yes. It's a 9.
A
So they have match nines. The lead is still 15 pins.
There's an old saying in any sport.
Big, big hit. And with all that wood around, that makes him feel good.
Any bowler that's bowling wants to go all offense, no defense. You don't want to just stay even with your bowler. You want to go out and mark as much as you can and force him to do twice as good.
Spare. So he has matched the mark, not literally, because one is a strike and one is a spare. But however, Peter had put the pressure on with the strike, and now Dick O'Connell comes back with a spare to match it.
Again, Peter can't carry that extra pin.
No, he's coming in either too full or just a little too far to the right on the head pin.
360 object on this shot.
Wow, look at that thing back up. It stopped before it went over there. For a 10. Yes, he has it. Now Peter has 5 boxes remaining. In completed frames, Dick O'Connell, our top seed, leads by 15. Peter Flynn gets... He stole a couple more. Now he's got a piece of wood that's almost a roadblock the way it is up against that. Boy, that's tricky, isn't it?
Yeah, Peter's got to watch out for that piece of wood that is facing him.
Nice. Wow! Beautifully done. I mean, that could not have been done more perfectly. He avoided that. Watch as he avoids this. See that? He left that piece of wood right there.
You got to watch out for that cap. That ball hits that cap and you miss them both.
This is a fill for Dick O'Connell. It's 8. So Peter picked up 1 pin on that exchange. That makes it 14 pins.
Dickie can actually miss this shot, although he doesn't want to. He can miss it to the head pin side, and he'll still carry.
That's a biggie. That's a biggie. A spare opposite a 10. We are running out of boxes. Also out of time a little bit, but we're going to stay here.
It was only time before things heated up.
That hurt. Just 2.
Again, another skip off.
Now he's up by 16. All right, 1-7-10. But this is the third ball, and he's opposite a spare. Box. So Peter automatically picks up 2 more and it's back to 14. And Peter will hope for a big fill right now.
Peter throws a strike and we've got a new ball game right here.
He won't. That's a tough spare leave. Wow. 7.
It's not too bad because he's got the wood that'll guide the 2 pin into the 5.
Did not get numero uno.
You got to hit the head pin on that one.
A 10 box. It is a 7 pin difference in completed boxes with 4 of them to go for Dick O'Connell, 3 of them for Peter Flynn. Big strike for Peter Flynn. This is not over.
The last 2 to fall.
Now Dick O'Connell comes up. He's opposite a 10 and a strike, and his lead has been shaved to 7. 2 full on the head pin right now.
We have a match. Dickie wants a big out of this one so he can come back and hopefully mark in the next box.
Now he wants to, if possible, match the 10
so he doesn't lose any. He lost one, so it's six pins. And he's opposite a strike, as you can see. We're getting down to the final. Who's going to walk away with $10,000? And you are watching it as it is happening. This is live.
Three pin the object pin, hopefully with the wood. In between the three and the five, that'll carry the seven. The pin you got to watch out for again is the nine pin.
Oh, what a costly miss that was.
Heavy barn burner.
Oh, baby. Hang on to your seats. We're coming down to the final two boxes. He loses another pin. It is down to five, and Peter Flynn has two bonus balls.
Not a high-scoring match. It'll keep you on the edge of your chair.
Boy, I'll say. Peter Flynn. No, just a little bit too straight. Five on the first ball.
Again, Peter's not getting the rotation on the ball that he wants, and it's not working for him like it normally does.
Obviously. The fill is six.
One pin.
He leads by one, and he has an eight ball. A one pin lead. However, he has only put an eight box in the nine. One pin in the match is the lead right now for Peter Flynn. However, he's put an eight box in the nine. Now he has a chance for a mark. Six and ten over on the right.
Although we have wood in front of that 6-10, that's out a little bit ways from those two pins, and a lot of times that piece of wood will spin and miss that 10 pin. It's not as easy a shot as it looks.
Let's see if he can drive it into that 6 and 10 and get it. He did. All right. Peter Flynn, leading by one in completed boxes, has thrown an 8 in the ninth, a spare in the 10th, and he'll be hoping for a big wallop here.
Depending upon what he fills this spare with, puts a lot more pressure on Dick.
It's a thin hit. He gets only four.
It's exactly what Dick was hoping for, to be honest with you.
Dick O'Connell needs a mark. He needs 26 to tie, 27 to win.
Dick needs one mark with a nice fill. And that's not the way.
Not that way. Not that way. All right. Now he's got to try to get at least two of these.
Dick's looking for.
And then obviously
nine,
we'll
at least. Maybe he can get lucky enough to grab the 10 and then come back with a mark in the 10th. Puts a lot of pressure on a bowler in that last box.
That's what he needs. I was thinking he had a 113. I was forgetting he already had the 10 for the spare. So he's got to strike. That close. That close. Peter Flynn has done it.
This is not at all an easy shot. The only thing that helps him here is the fact that he's got two pieces of wood that he can shoot at.
Here in this, let's see, we got a one. He needs four. He
think I'm not excited? Holy mackerel, I can't even add.
My hands are sweaty.
Concentrating so hard on the third string that I was forgetting about the first string. So, we'll be back to present the checks right after this.
Still driving that Hyundai, huh, big guy?
Yep.
Did you notice the machine I bought?
No.
Oh, man. I'm talking sexy. I mean, fight off the female sexy car.
Where is it?
Oh, it's in the shop right now.
Oh. The Hyundai Excel isn't built to impress the neighbors. It's built to impress its owners.
Would you be heading downtown, huh, big guy?
The dependable Excel from Hyundai. Cars that make sense.
It's a wave, a new wave. It's a Coca-Cola rave.
Enter the Double Wave Vacation Sweepstakes from your local Coca-Cola bottler. Visit the Magic Kingdom at Walt Disney World to see Cinderella's Castle. You'll fly via U.S. Air, serving over 100 cities every business day across the U.S. and Canada. Then fly to see Europe's great castles. Listen to Kiss 108 for a chance to win a 1988 Renault Medallion, a car without compromise. Details where you shop for Coke. Catch the wave at Walt Disney World with Coke.
Weekends, something like a crackle butt, more like a snack, just for you snackers, crunchy delight, kind of like a crackle butt with more snack bite. Oh, they're thin and square and they're light as air and they're honest to goodness lip smackers, just for you snackers, something like a crackle butt, more like a snack.
Try our low salt, nutty and cheese flavors too.
Nabisco.
Pure spring water with its crystal clear taste is bottled where it flows, on that mountaintop in Maine.
Ice Mountain, pure spring water, fresh as morning dew. If you can't come to Ice Mountain comes to you.
Candlepin Bowling is sponsored in part by your neighborhood True Value Hardware store.
Well, we didn't break any records so far as scores are concerned, but we sure had ourselves an hour and a half plus of bowling, didn't we? A lot of excitement. And Peter Flynn, I know it has to be a big disappointment to you, but you've got this trophy from the Ace Trophy Company, $5,000 plus that sensational three strikes in a row for another $1,050. And you had to wait until he made you wait until the very, very end there. And
yeah,
had you
hanging
by a friend, about
when
right?
I got that spare in the last box. I didn't get enough on it. I had a real bad feeling about that.
I had a bad feeling, too, because I was so mixed up. I forgot about the first of the two strings, and I had you winning at that particular point.
That's all right.
But the real fact is, of course, that Dick has done it, and you were a sensational bowler. You gave us a great thrill, one we've never had before with the three strikes in a row. And it's not bad to walk away with 6,050.
No, it's not bad.
Okay. We'll see you again, I'm sure, very soon. Okay. Here's our champ. He did it.
And he worked hard at it, too.
Well, I'll tell you, you know, when you had the four marks in a row in the first string, it looked like you were going to blow them away.
Geez, I had the ball work, and then I just got off the head pin for a couple of boxes.
And you know
there.
When you got the mark, the first mark in the second string, looked like, oh, man, this is going to be a piece of cake. Then all of a sudden, you're filled with a five, and you got a seven in the next box, huh?
Well, it's tough, you know. There's a lot of pressure here, being here alive, and you just get overexcited, and when you start missing the head pin, it's
tough. What you did in the last box.
Well, I had to do it.
$5,000 plus $100 in bonus money, a great big trophy from the Ace Trophy Company. And who are these three people?
This is Elisa, Katie, and Adam.
They're a little happy?
Yeah, I think they're real happy.
not any happier than you are, right?
Seeing that we leave.
You are happy? I bet you are. Okay. $5,100, and you are our champion of our club show and a very deserving champion.
I just want to say hi to my mom and dad who are watching.
Okay. Hi, mom and dad. O'Connell. Okay, that's it. I am Don Gillis. I want to thank Tim Lipke for working with me. And remind you, the ladies will be back next Saturday. Tony Marie Baldinelli will be our defending champion against the challenge of Lisa Orlandi. I will see you then. Be there, please. Bye-bye, everybody.